today's session. In today's session, we are doing digital input-output functions. So, digital input-output functions are very useful for your mini projects or you can say industrial products, because all sensors, maximum sensors operates in digital function. For example, digital means 0 and 1. So this session is to understand digital output function, to understand digital input function. Then we are doing some mini projects like fire alarm, burglar alarm, automatic light, etc. And we are seeing industrial products, like industrial products are touch free sanitizer dispenser, LED sign boards. So we'll see these topics in today's activity. So digital output operation and digital input operations. So you should know the instructions for digital output operations. That instructions are is pin mode pin comma output. So in this M is capital, and here you have to write down the pin number. Then if you want to make that pin high, the next instruction is digital write pin high. W is capital and high is also capital. Then if you want to make it low, digital write pin low. So only these three instructions are required for digital output operation. But for digital input operation, you require only two instructions, that is pin mode, pin number and input. So by using this instruction, you can make any pin as an input. And digital read pin number, so R is capital. All these instructions are case sensitive. So whenever it is capital, you have to write down capital. If it is small, you have to write down small. And this pin mode instruction is used in setup loop. And remaining instructions are used in continuous loop. Setup, these two are used in setup and these are in loop. Now before starting our practical session, we have to see some shield. So shield, what is the meaning of shield? So shield are boards that can be plugged on top of Arduino PCB, extending its capability. So you have to add extra board on Arduino. So there are different types of shields and they follow the same philosophy as original toolkit. So they are easy to mount and cheap to produce. So we'll see different shields and how it is mounted. So this is one shield we can mount on top of the Arduino board. So the shields are mounted on top of the Arduino board. So there are different shields like this. So these shields are these are joystick shield, LCD shield, then GSM shield. You can see that also. This is GSM shield, this is Wi-Fi shield, this is motor driver shield, this is sensor shield, this is general purpose shield. On this shield there are switches, 7 segment display, buzzer. So to perform all practicals you can use these shields. You can get the data of these shields from this above website. So all specifications of shield you will get this. There are n number of websites, but on this website you will get the details about this shield. Now to perform our practical, we are using my own shield. I had designed my own shield and this is the picture of my own shield. And this is the PCB layout, top view of the shield. So in this shield, these four pins are analog input, A0, A1, A2, A3. Then this is LCD contrast adjustment. This is LCD and this is LCD contrast adjustment. This is power supply LED. Then I had inserted relay as a switch. To operate the relay, I had used a relay driver transistor as a switch. This is a diode and LED indicator. Then again I had used buzzer and buzzer driver. To give input, I had used switch to give input. Here you can connect any serial device like GSM, GPS, ZigBee, etc. The pin configuration of these are same as Arduino. So same as Arduino, RX, TX, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7, like this. Here you can connect digital sensor at pin number 8. I had put LEDs, green LED, white LED, pink LED, green LED, white LED. So pin number 0 is RX, pin number 1 is TX, pin number 2 is RS pin of LCD, pin number 3 is enable pin of LCD, pin number 4, 5, 6, 7 are LCD D4 to D7. I had connected switch at pin number 8. I had connected buzzer at pin number 9. I had connected relay at pin number 10. I had connected LED, pink LED at pin number 13, green at 12 and white at 11. So in our today's activity, we are using this shield. This is my designed by me, and these are the pin diagrams. So you cannot change the pin for this shield. These are compulsory. So we will see the digital out operation. So in that, first point is initialization. So I will initialize the pin number 13 as LED pin. Then second part is setup. So in setup, I will initialize that pin, whether it is input or output. So this is digital output operation. So I will make this pin mode LED, output. So this is output pin. Next, loop. So in loop, I will write the LED pin high or low, and in between high low, I will use delay. So digital write LED high, wait for some time. Digital write LED low, wait for some time, and repeat the things because it is written in loop. So this is my simple program to give digital out signal. So we will perform the practical on LEDs, then relay, buzzer. Next activity is digital in and out. In this, we will read the signal, input signal. If it is low, then we will give signal to the output. So first type is initialization. So INT switch is connected to pin number 8. INT buzzer is connected to pin number 9. So when switch is pressed, output buzzer turns on. Setup. Switch is input and buzzer is output. So pin mode buzzer, output, pin mode switch, input. Then loop. Loop is continuous process. In this loop, our first instruction is INT button state equal to digital read switch. So I am reading the switch status. As it is digital, its output is either high or low. Now by default, output of all sensors, output of this switch when pressed is low. So I am checking if button state equal to low. When it is equal, then it is comparison. Less than equal, comparison. Greater than equal, comparison. So button state equal. So we are comparing whether it is low or high. So if it is low, digital write buzzer high. So buzzer turns on. Else digital write buzzer low. So buzzer turns off if switch is not pressed. So this program is very important for any mini project based on digital input output. Even for hand sanitizer also, we are using this program where switch is replaced by sensor and buzzer is replaced by relay or sanitizer pump. So this is the program. Now we will start our actual hands-on for digital in out, and also we'll see some mini project and industrial products. Okay, so we will start our hands-on in real practical session. So for that, we have to open our Arduino program. So I will open the Arduino. So file, new. So I will open the new program. New. So first step is INT pink LED equal to 13. Then in setup, I have to initialize that pin. So pin mode P LED, output. Then in loop, first I will make that pin high. So digital write P LED, high. Then wait for some time for that delay into bracket 500. So I am using 500 millisecond delay. Then again I will copy this program and I will write digital write P LED low. After writing program, tools, auto format. So automatically that will be set. Then save your program. So file, save. So I will write LED blinking. Save. After saving, I will connect my hardware. So this is my hardware. And in this hardware, this is my pink LED. This is my pink LED. Right now it is off. Now I will upload the program. So I will click on upload. So when I am clicking on upload, compiling the sketch. Compiling means converting your program, C program, into machine language. After compiling, that program is loaded into microcontroller, that is uploading. Now here I am using pink LED, green LED, white LED. After this, we will write the code to blink all these LEDs, and then I will write the code to blink these LEDs in sequence. Now in this program, after changing this PLED, we will write the program to turn on and off this buzzer. After buzzer, we will write the program to turn on and off the relay. So right now it is compiling. Till I will explain the hardware. So relay is electromechanical switch. Electromechanical switch means mechanical switch operated by electrical signal. And to operate that relay, we are using relay driver, that is transistor, as a switch. Transistor operates at 0.7 volt. So we are using base resistor. See, done uploading. So done uploading, LED is blinking. If I want to blink this LED fast, so I will make this 500 equal to 100. And again, I will upload the program. So again, compiling the sketch. Whenever you do any change in the program, you have to compile this. So again, compiling and then uploading. Uploading. So done uploading. If you see, this LED is blinking faster as previous. So right now delay is 100 milliseconds. Now I will change the pin number only. So 13 is replaced by 12. 12 is for green LED. Now I will upload this. So 12 means green LED. You cannot connect LED directly, because LED operates on 1.5 volt and you are giving 5 volt. So LED may damage. So to avoid that, you have to use one resistor in series with the LED. Now uploading. If you see, now green LED is blinking because we have changed the pin. Now again, I will change the pin to 11. 11 is connected to pin number, 11 is connected to white LED. So my white LED will blink. So this operation is digital out operation. This is your digital out operation. So again, it is compiling. My program is same. I am just changing the pin number. See, white LED is up, operating. Now I will make it 10. So 10 is for relay. 10 is for relay. So relay will turn on and off, and you will see the flickering sound. Tick like this. So again, it is compiling. After compiling, it will upload the program for relay. So uploading. See, relay turns on and this yellow LED is blinking, and you hear the chattering sound. Tick. Now again, I will change this pin number 10 to 9. So again, uploading. So now I am using buzzer to upload. I am using buzzer for this practical. So buzzer will turn on and off. So compiling the sketch. Uploading. So you can hear the buzzer sound. T t t t t t t t t t t.